Happy Monday. Who could use some motivation on this Monday morning to quit porn for good, stop masturbating, and start reaching your full potential? Right? Show of hands. Well, I am here to help you out. I'm Dr. Trish Lee. I'm going to keep you motivated on Mondays. So let's start with today's Monday motivation. Okay, what are we going to cover today? Today we are going to talk about how to stay motivated in the three main areas that will pull you forward into your full potential. Number one, your work or your job or your purpose. Number two, your relationships. Number three, your hobbies, which also could involve your relationships or other people in your life. So we're going to break them down. We're going to give you some goals to anchor you in for the week and to keep you going. Okay, so number one, your work or what you go to do to make a living, which hopefully you are doing. Okay, I hope you love your work. If you don't, we should probably dig into that in a different video or in coaching, but if you don't love your work, that is going to be very difficult to anchor you into the future. But we're just going to assume that you at least like your work. So if you like your work, this is what I want you to do this week. I want you to come up with one work goal that excites you, that makes you feel good about trying to accomplish it. I want you to think of that goal that by Friday, you will have accomplished it. So it can't be a giant goal. It has to be a smaller, a SMART goal, as they call it in the business, which is one that is you're able to measure, you will be able to achieve by Friday so that you can use neuroscience to pat yourself on the back with success, a small win, so that you can keep moving forward. I want you to literally think of that goal right now and write it down or type it into your phone because I want you to accomplish that goal by Friday. It will do wonders for your brain. Okay, number two. I want you to think of your relationships. I want you to come up with a relationship goal for the week also. Maybe you're going to take your honey to dinner so you can build some intimacy. Maybe you're going to spend time playing a game with your children, not telling them what to do and not taking care of them, but actually playing a game with them. Maybe you're going to coffee clutch with some friends just to relax in the real world and let joy come back in by being able to be present with your friends. Now, what I want to talk about in this section is there's five types of intimacy. And you'll see online there's actually many different types, but there's five main categories. This is what I want you to go for this week. I want you to go for one of these five types of intimacy. Okay, there's emotional intimacy. Tell somebody how you feel. Get vulnerable. Share something about yourself. And my husband just did this the other day. He'd literally kill me if he knew I was telling you. But he told me a feeling that he was having. And I was literally blown away because he's never really shared, you know, feeling trepidatious about anything. And that really can connect us because we're sharing on new levels. So share an emotion, especially with your partner if you have one. Okay, there's intellectual intimacy, which this one I do all the time. I'm sure you can imagine that, right? Because I love me some intellect. But so intellectual intimacy is discussing ideas with someone, hopefully in a friendly banter type of way, and sharing your thoughts with someone, having them share their thoughts with you, and actually listen and be able to get intimate by sharing ideas. Then there is experiential intimacy. So this is the whole play a game with your kids. I played cards with my son Seamus and the Hubs the other day, and we had a great time. We were cracking ourselves up. That was an experience that we had together because all my other children were gone, and I never get time with just one kid, so that was really fun. It was an experience. It's Halloween time, so my two younger kids and I did some Halloween stuff yesterday. That's an experience that we shared together. The Hubs and I cut out time. We have date night. Sometimes we just lock ourselves in our bedroom. I literally bought a please do not disturb sign. And we just hang out. There's a couch in there. We just hang out and talk without being interrupted. So you can just have that experience of getting a weird do not disturb sign and cutting out 15 minutes with your partner where no one can interrupt you. So experiential. Next type of intimacy is physical intimacy. And yes, that includes sexual intimacy, but it also includes hugs and touch and massage and just sitting close next to each other and cuddling on the couch while you watch TV. So you could build this type of physical intimacy in for the week too. It goes very far. And lastly is spiritual intimacy. So really connecting in your spirituality and sharing some of your thoughts about, you know, whatever you think is a greater good in this world and connecting in that way. So I want you to go for at least one type of intimacy with the people in your life this week that are important to you. Okay, so now like and subscribe to this channel if you're getting value out of these videos, because I want you to be able to get the notifications, because I have a couple things planned to keep you motivated throughout the week, and I want you to get those notifications. So if you're into it, please do so, because that would be awesome. Okay, so now let's talk about lastly in your hobbies. Your hobbies or the things that you like to do. Now, you need to make a goal for the week to be able to go do a thing that you love. Not your work, and it might be with other people, but it doesn't have to be. And the reason you need to do this is because it puts you into actual flow state in the world. And you know that one of my great mentors, Mihai Csikszentmihalyi, who is the founder of the research behind flow state, and flow state is when your brain is just humming along in the zone, and it gives you the perfect amount of neurochemical transmitter release in your brain. Not a huge dump, like you're getting artificially from pornography or masturbation, but the perfect amount to make your brain feel good. You need to give your brain that throughout the week. And that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to create that perfect flow in your work by picking a goal that feels good to you. Some flow, which might be a little harder with the people in your life right now, at least for your brain, but creating some of that. And it might be uncomfortable, honestly, doing some of those intimacies, but when you practice week to week, it's gonna get better. Then in your hobby, if you like to play darts, go throw some darts. If you like playing pool, go shoot some stick. If you like baking, if you like cooking, go do that. It will put your brain in flow, and it's gonna give you the neurochemical release that you need, especially as you're quitting your PMO and your FAP habit. So go for that, okay? Because those three areas will really help you out this week. Okay, now here's your bonus brain tip. Your bonus brain tip is cut out time for your brain training this week. So you can brain train with technology, and I've explained it in a different video. You can brain train without technology. This week, we're gonna start establishing the habit for you. So this is what it's gonna look like. I need you to pick 3 times a week minimum. You can do up to 7 if you want. Honestly, you could do up to 57 if you wanted, but what I want you to do is pick 3 times a week when you're going to go into your new sanctuary. Sanctuary is what I call my chair, where I sit and I do my meditation, I do my neurofeedback brain training, I do my best thinking, but if I'm in that chair, my kids know, and you know, I got a lot of kids, so that's what I'm always, that's my filter. My kids know, you do not come in when mom's in the sanctuary, because literally, the sanctuary means I'm in the zone. Please don't interrupt me until I come back out. Find your sanctuary and start building a habit around sitting in it to calm your brain down. And so for this week, you can just sit in that chair, just sit in it for 5 minutes and don't do anything. Don't troll your phone, don't watch TV. You're literally just sitting in that chair and letting your brain come down. Again, it might create a little discomfort, but that's okay on week one, because that is what we are going for, because the more you practice, the easier it will get. And before you know it, you'll find your mind clearing and you'll find your brain slowing down and you'll find everything else that we just talked about becoming easier. Okay, if you are looking for help in this journey, I would absolutely be honored to help you out. So go to my website at drtrishlee.com. I have an awesome course that's only $49. It's an entry point for us to work together. In the course, there's more information about coaching with me, about a consultation if you're interested, and some discounts on some brain training equipment if you're looking for it. So just get in that course. It's only $49 and we can start working together, because I'd absolutely love to help you. Okay, so remember, control your brain or it'll control you.